You are.
I can see it.
It's got no markings on it, but it's old. It's got some sort of a mark on it, stamp. The crest on it look lying on it, you see?
Like that bit you've just had, and that's what's happened is they've and these are all rejects, but that's a good thing that to have that to demonstrate that. A bit of wild rose in there. That's a decent angle here. Yeah, I know, but I mean, they'd have to put something to support it, wouldn't they, if they take all this top bit down here?
Well, I think they've got all that in hand.
Oh, have they? Yeah. That is a good chance.
I have a feeling these buildings went up about 1860, Dale.
Well, from that, we can date that.
I think these ones were up around about 1860, built as a brewery, initially.
Yeah.
I'm not real.
Oh,
yeah, the base.
Is that
written on there?
Is that big base there,
mate? Oh, you know what, some gloves for that.
See, that's from our big jug and bowl sets.
Yes.
You know. We've got these when they built the Leith Road, we found loads of them.
Interesting stuff, isn't it?
Yeah.
Let me know how you go on then, Gray, later on.
Alright, enjoy. Yep,
see you then.
Oh, it's 2 weeks today, Canal Bar.
You what, Tony?
2 weeks today, Canal
Bar. Oh, that's a bit better then, isn't it?
Yeah.
And
A bit lighter. Same kind of idea though. Same kind of pattern. Looks like they've been tight. Oh, that's very good. That's a tureen lid, that would have had an angle like a vegetable tureen or something. That would have come from old buildings or something. And they've just used it, haven't they, to fill in. Bloody hell, that's an 8-piece of kit, that. Fantastic. Ooh! Yep. Aye, that's from Samuel Barker and Son, Don Pottery, about 1870, that one. It's called the Lion and Pennant mark, that one. Very good. And there's another one with letters underneath. SB&S, that's what they put on it. That's a tureen lid again. That's been on the tureen now.